Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sanjay Sachdeva. I'm a practicing ENT surgeon from New Delhi. I'm a graduate and postgraduate from Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi. And I've been in practice for the last 32 years in the field of ENT. So that is, I think, a very important question that you asked, because earlier we diagnose this problem and earlier we start treating it, better are the results. Otherwise, we are going to have very severe morbidity and sometimes mortality also becomes very high. And we have seen that COVID, somehow the other, certainly has a predisposing factor of reducing the immunity in such a way that mucus grows very rapidly and becomes quite aggressive. So diagnosing is mainly based on clinical diagnosis. So if we have a prerequisite of a diabetes, steroids, antibiotics, ICU, prolonged ICU, increased ferritin or other inflammatory markers, and steroids given to these patients in prolonged respiratory problem because of COVID. So these patients have respiratory acidosis. So they are quite prone to get COVID. So you have to be proactive in finding out if these patients will, either during the COVID time or post-COVID also, a few days, 10 days, 7 days, 20 days, up to 10, 20 days, 30 days also last time we saw that after a month, these patients came with the mucormycosis. And the clinical signs are very, very remarkable. So patient will complain of severe pain on one side of the face or head and will complain of nasal blockage, bloody nasal discharge, and will also say that the patient, the cheek or the two teeth or the tip of the nose or some part of the face is getting anesthetic. So that is very remarkable for mucus. If that happens, and if you the patient is complaining of that, then please do not lose time. Immediately on clinical ground, start with antifungal treatment.